Hey, this is WhyBeAre with Maize, which is a game about sentient corn. At least that's what the Steam description tells me. I'm going into this game completely blind because it seems like it's more of an adventure puzzle game. And for those kinds of games, it's usually a lot more fun to do those blind versus knowing exactly what the solution is. Well, there goes the corn, I guess. I was staying quiet right there because I wanted to make sure I didn't talk over anything you guys might need to hear, but it turns out there's nothing that you actually needed to hear. Now, me being YBR, I know that I'm supposed to follow the corn, but I gotta get my bearings first and explore the area and see what's around here. So we got a lake or maybe a river over there behind a fence, and that seems like that's really the only thing to look at. Okay, let's go and find that corn. And apparently, not only can you use WASD and the mouse, you could also use SHIFT to run. See, me and my video game instincts, I'm all clicking buttons, I'm used to clicking, and boom, I found the run key, although I can't find the jump key. You can't see me, but I'm clicking all the buttons on my keyboard right now trying to find it, and I'm having, no luck with that. You would think spacebar, but spacebar is not doing it, and ooh, what is this? When the pointing hand icon appears, click the left mouse button to interact. Alright. Opened door panel. And then we have things I could click on, but I don't know what to do with them. A slot for a hand. Well, put your hand in it. A slot for a key and a slot for... No, a circular slot. I thought it was going to be a slot for a disc because, you know, they both say a slot for. For consistency, you would think a slot for a disc. No, the game got me there. So I guess in this direction, there is a house. Let's go to that house. So far, it looks like there's no alternative paths in this corn maze. It's just a single... Never mind, that looks... Oh, no, that's not actually a path. For a second, I thought it was actually an alternative path, right as I said there wasn't any. And now there actually might be... No. This game's tricking me. I keep thinking, oh, yeah, that's another path. No, it ain't. You know what? Here's the solution that works for a lot of mazes in games. Hug the right side and just keep hugging it. Usually, eventually, you'll get out of the maze. I say usually because that's not always the case, but it works a lot of the time. So let's see what happens here. And is that the end of the maze? Yes, it is! Or at least it's probably where I wanted to go. So, ha! My strategy works! So we click the left mouse button to pick up items when the grab icon appears. Okay. We just picked up an English muffin. You did a great job picking up that item. A new path is open to you. All right. Items you can use will be added to your inventory. Story items will be added to your folio. Okay, so what is this? It's a welcome note. Item added to folio. Okay, well, anything else on this desk? Doesn't appear that there's anything you could do with it. Now, how do I access my folio? I mean, I could just start bashing keys, but the game will tell me eventually, right? So press E to examine your equipped item for clues on how to use it. Well, it's not the folio, but let's go ahead and... do that. So the English muffin is hard as granite. This muffin is most definitely nowhere near fit for consumption. Despite how much you try, all you've done is given yourself a headache. Well, there's your problem. You're not supposed to rub the muffin on your forehead. You're supposed to put it in your mouth and break your teeth. Obviously, that's what they did wrong. And this time I'm hugging the left wall. I don't know why. I just decided it looks like this was more of a hidden area. Turns out it's just blocked by a bunch of boxes. It's mega orange, produced in the US of A. Kind of looks like the size for a big box of paper, but I don't really see anything on it that says exactly what it is besides the thing that says Supersonic Postal Service. So it could be just about anything in that box. The world will never know unless, of course, we eventually open the box, in which case we will know. Press the spacebar to look at your story items in the folio. Perfect. See, I knew it would tell me eventually. So this is the welcome note. It's a note, lazily scribbled. Includes a stock greeting and encourages the reader to enjoy the complimentary snack on the desk. Notes to the reader to mind the boxes and also says, open the big door and we'll probably say hello. Alright, so how do we get out of here? Spacebar again. Okay, there we go. So we got a sign over there that says there's a, looks like an elevator. Oh no, it's that door we just saw. That's probably what's over there. And it's actually done on... like a weird pile of desks. That's interesting. Just throw the desk down and make it into a sign and throw the chair there. Yep, that's it. We're done. What is that? That kind of looks like a Fiero. Like, it's definitely a mid or rear engine car because it has vents on the rear right here. Like, if the engine was in the front, that would be totally illogical. Why would you have vents on your trunk? Like, that just makes no sense. Actually, you could actually see through that vent and you see there's grass there. So that's definitely something you could see through. So yeah, mid-engine probably just looking at the way the vents are positioned. And again, it looks a lot like a Fiero. Like, I don't know exactly what a Fiero looks like off the top of my head, but like when I'm thinking about it, it's like, yeah, that's a Fiero, man. So let's go say hello. When you press the plate, or when you see the place icon, you can use an item. Click the left mouse button to use your equipped item. All right, let's use my English muffin on the door, which apparently does nothing. So let's see if there's anywhere else we could go. I see a sign that we just looked at, but I also see a different path through the corn. We have a statue of a fat man right there. I've seen fatter men before, but the way the sun shines makes him look really important, doesn't it? Like the sun is just shining right on that statue. What do we got here? A broken shovel handle. Oh yeah, this is definitely the way I want to open the door. So equipped inventory items using the scroll wheel or one and two keys. I'll just scroll as fast as I possibly can because I can. There you got some more boxes of paper, which just seems like they're there to block your path. They're not actually something you can interact with. Anything else around here? Doesn't appear so. So what's it say about the shovel? Completely useless for shoveling dirt, but helpful if you want to tip something over. You immediately think of the wardrobe on the second floor of the farmhouse, because you didn't particularly like how it looked at you, and would like to ruin its day. What do I got, x-ray vision? My guy's just like, there's a wardrobe right there, I know it, I hate it, I'm gonna hit it with my shovel. Does that mean the shovel handle is not used to, open the door? I guess not, okay. Well, are there any other paths, then? Did you leave the keys in your Fiero? Now you can't do anything with that. You can kind of tell there is a modeled interior on it, though, because you can see a steering wheel shape right here and a little bit of a dash. Even though the windows are so filthy, you could barely see through it. Oh, aha, back door. No, but there is stuff in there. Like, I see something glowing up in there. Looks like the game does a pretty good job of that, though. Like, if it's something you could actually interact with, it glows. You don't have to, like, go and hunt for things. And even if my mouse cursor isn't on it, it's glowing when you get anywhere near it. Like, we could be that far away, it starts to glow. So I like that. So this is the chicken coop door, which we just opened up. And it says, click the left mouse button to interact when the pointing hand icon appears. So we got a farmhouse key right there. We'll take it. Because I totally always put my key in the chicken coop. That would make no sense. Like, if you don't want any security and you just need an alarm, sure, you could put it in the chicken coop because the chickens will be loud and somebody tries to take your key. But, yeah, they're going to take the key. I don't think a bunch of chickens are going to stop them. Especially some ones that live in a coop, which will probably be pretty tame compared to, like, a crazy wild chicken in the wild. Although, I don't think wild chickens are even that crazy. No matter how many times you press it, Q still does nothing. So now you got me pressing Q. I didn't even know what Q does, but now I'm pressing it. So, a rusty nail jammed in the wall. Doesn't seem like we can do anything with that. Oh, wait, let's try English muffining the nail. How about broken shovel? No. Now, what's the key actually say? Your mind explodes with the possible uses for this item, but you settle on key to unlock a nearby farmhouse and never think of any other possibility again. Well, I mean, it doesn't make sense. It's called the farmhouse key, after all. So there's a mediocre rock, which was added to the folio. Okay. Apparently my guy puts rocks in his folio. This is a rock you found near an outhouse. You don't know why you have it. It is absolutely mediocre in every way possible. Its name is Chauncey. Wow, that rock is a lot like me. My name should be Chauncey. That's what I'm gonna call myself from now on. I'm gonna be Chauncey with whatever video game I'm playing. And then I'll forget it promptly after this video and we'll be back to YBR. But hey, it's a thought. So does this key work on the back door? No, it doesn't appear to be a key for the back door. It's probably the front door because the front door glows and everything. Back door doesn't even glow. We have now opened the door. And the key is gone. So what do we got there? Is that like a boot? Yeah, it's kind of hard because it's so dark. Up here, we got a reindeer hat. I was about to say John Deere, but that's a reindeer hat. Okay. What do we got in this room? Is that a globe of Mars? Like, it looks like it could be Mars just because of the color, but I know it has to be Earth because it makes no sense. Why would you have a globe of Mars? An invoice for a carved wooden statue? Sure, I'll take that. Actually, I'll even read it. An invoice for a commissioned wooden statue. Cost is in the hundreds of thousands. Wow. Items on this list include chopping down a large oak tree, carved statue out of oak tree, and hospital bills for injuries sustained chopping down oak tree. Well, apparently you hired somebody pretty incompetent to have to pay that third charge. Wait, is it just me or does that total look like it says 2 million? It does. It says $2,500,000. That's, I wouldn't say cost in the hundreds of thousands. I would say cost in the millions. What in the world kind of statue could be that expensive? Was the statue I saw wooden? Oh, it might be. We'll take a quick peek at this thing a little bit closer to see if we can see the texture on it. And I guess that does have the right color to be a wooden statue. So some poor sap paid $2,500,000 for that. What? I have to have read that number wrong, right? I don't know. Too lazy to look back at it now. I'm just going to assume I read it wrong. A really boring mystery novel added to the folio. Having no talent at the genre, the author mistakenly revealed the murder's identity on the first page, and spent the rest of the novel outlining a story about the detective buying a pair of pants. That sounds like the kind of story I would read. Like, I could totally relate to buying pants because I've done that many times in my life. Got a fruit crate. What's it say about the fruit crate? Despite what the name would suggest, this crate was specifically used to hold a large number of pine cones in order to start a collection. The collection currently sits at zero. What a deceptively named crate. I'm gonna just call it the pinecone crate from now on. Or what is this? A sausage grinder. Something is jammed inside and I cannot click on it. Okay, fine. Got some rancid canola oil, which I clicked before I could even see the name of. Though the smell is strong enough to overcome a herd of yaks, you could use it to loosen something you need to remove. For some reason, an image of a gloved hand pops into your head, leading directly to you walking straight into a wall. Well, okay then. That's an interesting image. And there is the walking into a wall to match up with that. What is that? A bathtub plug? Sure, I'll take that. This particular plug fits perfectly into the bathroom sink on the first floor of the farmhouse. It is also a talking plug, but due to a bad case of laryngitis, you will never know that. Bah, but I do because I read the descriptions in your face. So put it in the sink. Why did I do that? I don't know. Can I put the muffin in the sink? No. Oh, I could put the canola in the sink. Great. And the smell is worse than imagined. Why in the world would you even put that in the sink? That makes no sense. Oh, there's a medicine cabinet. Let's see. What is that? Like, can't tell. Oh, they're toenail clippers. Vigilant as you are when it comes to personal hygiene, the only two things these clippers will do for you are grip something lodged in a wall and give you a 100% tinnitus guarantee. That's it. Something gripped into a wall. Oh! Maybe it's the nail I saw earlier. And my mouse, or my hand, was not in the right position there. Press C to crouch and C again to not crouch. And apparently not crouch is a proper noun. You can do this forever. Prove it. I bet I'll die before forever happens. And this is like a really jerky movement, isn't it? It's like, just boom, we're down. Boom, we're up. There's no animation to it, really. So we got a concealed switch. We can go ahead and click that. And then unlock secret door, making it much less secret. I bet that's the secret door. Ha! I'm a genius! So what do we got down here? I guess I don't need to crouch anymore. A fuse box missing a fuse. Is there anything I can use for a fuse? Muffin, shovel, no. Fruit case, no. Nail clippers? Apparently not. I thought maybe nail clippers could kind of work. Okay. Anything else down here? Doesn't appear like there is. What we got over here? Ah, we can open a latch so the cellar doors are open, and that's just the back of the house. Nothing new there. Guess now we could head upstairs because it's the only part of the house I haven't seen. So let's see what's up here. I know there's a wardrobe somewhere that my guy really does not like, and I really do not like the color of this room. It is a hideous purple-blue color. So we got a bobby pin right there, so we'll grab that. What's it say? Extremely useful for picking a lock, but you mistakenly thought it was a pencil and wrote a very detailed account of your day up to that point, and didn't notice there was no ink until a few hours later. Wow. My guy is, not so bright, is he? He's actually pretty dumb. So he could place the fruit crate there? And then, this is the wardrobe! Shove it with the shovel! Handle. I just call it a shovel, but it's actually just part of a shovel. Now we can see out the window. What the heck? For a second, I thought that was a person right there. It's just the, a water spigot or something, I think. So what's up here? The attic? And what's in the attic is what I should be saying. Don't really see anything except for a mallet. And what is this? An item can be placed here. We place the toenail clippers there? How about the bobby pin? Nope. They look like they might be the right shape, but they were not. Anything over here? What is this? A burnt lab report. Sure, I'll read that. Much of it can't be read, but the words abject failure appear several times. So does hurt feelings, sentient corn stalks, and why did we do this? Except for the third one, I can relate to all of those. And every time I pick up something, I gotta think, wait, is it E? Or is it spacebar? Because I always gotta feel like I'm gonna hit the wrong one if I don't think about it. Was there anything else in this room? Doesn't look like it. What about the room to our right? Nope, nothing in here but some boxes, and we can look out the window. Haven't really seen anything of interest out these windows yet, so I don't know if there's really worth doing. And now I've basically seen everything I can think of in the house, so let's go try to grab that nail. I think it was by the chicken coop and not by the statue. I can't remember for sure. Yeah, this is it. This is where the nail was. Should be in the bathroom. And there was... Wait, why do you have one of these when you got a bunch of bathrooms in your house? Like, is your plumbing broke? So you just decide, you know what? I don't want to fix the plumbing. I'm just going to dig a hole and poop in a hole. I just realized how weird and dumb that is. So what's it say about the nail? For some reason, the first thing that pops in your head is that it would be a good conductor of electricity. Possibly as a fuse. You are very strange. Yes. Yes, I am. So let's go ahead and stick that in the fuses. Yeah, use rusty nails as a fuse. Against safety regulations. Don't tell OSHA. Just kidding, it's not an occupation, so OSHA has nothing to do with this. Haha. So we restored power to the farmhouse, and it's slightly less dark than before. Although still pretty dark. I was wondering, could we use the bobby pin to grab what was ever inside of here? Nah, it doesn't seem like it. Said it was used to pick locks, so I'll have to assume that's true. Has anything changed up in here? Ooh, that's a creepy looking picture right there. I did not notice that when it was dark. Also, you could hear the electricity. That's kind of weird. Like, I'm gonna be quiet for a minute so you can see if you can hear it over the music, because it is quiet, but I hear something and I assume that's the electricity. And I say that, but then I don't hear it anymore, so I apologize for my lying and, just believe me, you could hear it. Now you can't. I guess it was when it was first powering up you could hear it. I thought maybe it was the positioning. Nope, it's gone. So is this a globe of the USA, or planet Earth with USA, I should say? Yeah, but USA cannot be seen because it's on the wrong side. There's no spin button. How disappointing. Anything else in this room? Doesn't appear to have anything else. What about upstairs? Has anything changed upstairs? Looks the same. And looks the same. I could run. I forgot about that. What about up here? Anything changed up here? Nothing there that's different? Nope. Looks like everything up here is the same as well. So let's go back downstairs and... Oh. Wow. I can be dumb sometimes. I somehow missed that there was a place you could go over here. That's embarrassing. Although, I did know you could run way before the game told you what key it was, so I got that going for me at least, I guess. What does it say? I can't read it. I'm too close. It's just messing with me. It says... I don't know. I still can't read what that text on top says. It's just, no matter how close or far I am, It seems like it's just kind of hard to read. If you want to decipher it, go ahead. I'm not going to spend the time. Instead, I'm going to go inside of here and see what's up on the barn. Horseshoes. Do we need a horseshoe? No, we do not. What is over here? We need this spinning wheel thing. What does it do? I don't know, but I need it. We also need that press right there. I don't know. You can make some things out of this stuff. A book titled Corn of the World. Yeah, I definitely need that. I love corn. And I hit the wrong button. I told you I would. A book outlining the differences and similarities of corn species across the globe. Several chapters also discuss the color yellow. A few species are circled in a red pen, while no, no, no appears in many places across the book in blue pen. See, there's going to be sentient corn eventually. I promise you that. It's just, when will we see it? Can we climb up to that? No, there's really no way to actually climb up things you see. A little deceptive. Like, you can just walk, and that's really it. That's all you can do. What do we got here? One half of a diagram. All right, let's look at the diagram then. Did it again. A diagram torn in half contains very complicated looking equations scribbled in orange pen, a drawing of a person, and a DNA helix. Looks very important. You tried to eat it at first, but changed your mind when you couldn't find any salt. You know, that's kind of interesting. I've never heard of complex equations in orange ink. Everybody who writes complex equations uses blue or black ink. Something tells me these people are a little bit crazy. All right, we got a broom now. There's a pile of something or other you can sweep up with this, but you already knew that. What you didn't know was that this broom is haunted. This will not affect your adventure in any way, as the ghost is currently away on business. Oh yeah, well, what if I waited a week? Would the ghost be back and then he'd be like, "Who dares take my broom?" And yeah, I don't know. He'd do ghostly things, like haunt me. I bet it will affect my adventure. They're lying to me. I know it will affect me somehow. So that's all I saw in there, so I guess got some more area we could explore over here. Ooh, a tractor. Can I hotwire the tractor with my bobby pin? Nah, it doesn't look like there's anything you could actually click on. And then we have another pile of boxes over here. All right. Piles of boxes everywhere. And I have no idea why they would have so many orange boxes. That's fun to do. It's obnoxious, but it's fun to do. So I'm going to go ahead and hug the left wall now, and that looks like it's to some sort of silo. Although the silo is to my right. I said I was going to hug the left wall. We're going to stick to what I said. Eventually, we'll probably get back to the silo. If not, I'll actually come to see what it is. Stop pressing Q. I wasn't pressing Q, but now you're going to make me. I'm hitting Q now, and there's nothing you can do about it. So there's another dead end with some boxes. And that is not a silo. That's like some crazy looking thing. And oh, hey, there's a dead guy. That's interesting. And there's a gloved, severed hand. Well, yeah, I want that. Sure. He looks like a mad scientist for sure. With that kind of haircut, that's a definite mad scientist look. A very fashionable fedora. Yeah, I'll take that. What is this? I don't know. It's not telling me. For now, let's look at the fedora. A very fashionable fedora worn by a very fashionable person. Due to this, you are not putting it on your head, as you have not earned the right. On the other tag, the owner wrote his name, Fernando. I'm sorry you're dead, Fernando. What is this one then? A charred name tag. It took you several hours of staring, but you managed to deduce that the name tag in fact belonged to a dead person. It was the dead person it was near. And that his name was Fernando. Well, I figured that out by the hat, you know. It took you several more hours to notice that the dead person was a lab assistant, and then 5 more minutes to realize you were trying to read the whole thing upside down the whole time. Well, yeah, that could definitely be an issue if you read it upside down. Kind of weird, like everything is still moving even though I'm in the menu. Video games have been doing that recently where the pause is not actually a pause. I don't like that. I don't like that one bit. I assume there's some technical reason they do it, but still, I don't like it. I told you eventually we'd end back up at the silo, didn't I? And it's locked, so how about we use the bobby pin? Perfect. Ooh, that chain animation, so smooth. You open the silo door, and that looks like something I'd want to sweep. Alright, we cleared the pile of corn kernels with the broom, and then we have a needle-nose pliers, or a pair of needle-nose pliers. What does it say about that? You saw something in that sausage grinder that could be removed with these pliers. You know this because you spent an uncomfortable amount of time trying to pull it out with your hands, making no progress whatsoever. At least I didn't grind my hands. It could have been way worse, couldn't it have? An old telescope? Yeah, I want that. Manufactured about a century ago, this telescope telescope's effective range is the tops of low-hanging trees, possibly because its lenses were put on backwards. Looks like it was used frequently with varying results. What were they actually looking at? Like, I guess they were just storing it in there because they were basically looking directly at a wall. It's not like this is some sort of clear roof silo you could see through or something like that. A weathered, tattered blueprint. Yeah, I'll take that as well. Though it's hard to make out, this blueprint looks like it's for the construction of a very large and very poorly planned facility, with a farm situated on top of it. The facility itself actually set an architectural record for having the largest number of corridors that lead absolutely nowhere. And then he even says, why did we build all of this on the piece of blueprint? Alright, let's go to the sausage grinder and see what was inside of it. And use my fancy pair of pliers that look a little bit rusty and gross. Although, if you want to talk about gross, yeah, my guy picked up a severed hand. Pretty sure that's way grosser than the pliers, by far. And I'm assuming the severed hand will be used on the thing we saw earlier where it said a spot for a hand. Then we also have an old CD. Maybe that's the thing that's for the circle. It does say top secret on it. Well, it did. It's so faded you could barely tell. Did I ever actually read what the CD said? An old CD, its label faded, pressed on the first batch of CDs ever created. This brand was notoriously expensive and even more unreliable, making even the greatest of symphonies sound like something a concussed elephant would make while stumbling around a music shop. Hey, that's what my outros will sound like when I finally make them. They are still planned. I said I was going to make outros a long time ago. That has not come to fruition yet, but it will. So what do we got in the sausage grinder? Warped key fob. All right, what's to say about that? This warped key fob would be useful if you could flatten it back to its original shape. At first, you try to do this by staring very hard at it. It didn't work. So you set out to find a tool that will do the job much better. Well, I got a mallet, so it's probably that. And oh, yeah. Something about the canola oil and a severed hand. Oh, that's gross. Now I'm not carrying a severed hand in a glove. I'm just carrying the hand itself. I'm just going to pretend that's my dude's hand. It makes me feel a little bit better. Instead of thinking, oh, dude, I'm carrying around a dead man's hand. That's just gross and weird. Also, what's even weirder is the hand has skin on it. The dude was a skull, though. Like, what kind of preservation methods were used on this thing? Got a little bit mixed up on which way to go. I'm trying to remember where was the place to place something. I think that looked very similar to the key fob. So if we place it there and smack it with the hammer, perfect. And it has like a DNA symbol on it, which was the same thing I saw on that door. So we're going to head to that door and see if we can unlock it. We got the three things. We got a hand, a key fob, and a disc. And a muffin, just in case we need an English muffin. Why would we need an English muffin to open the door? I don't know, but why am I carrying around an English muffin still? That's the better question. And to that, I still don't know. And after we get to that door, that'll probably be the end for this video, just because we have been playing for about maybe a half hour or so at this point. Depends how much I decide to kind of clean up the editing. But usually for blind playthroughs, you don't do too much editing. So probably maybe if I cleaned up about 5 minutes of it, it would be 28 minutes in, which is what I would guess. Just putting out random numbers there. So it's a slot for a hand. Okay. And then the slot for the key fob and the slot for this. Well, I almost said it again. A slot for a disc, but it's not that. Well, that opened kind of violently. Just dropped.
Hey. Hey! Hey! You must answer a riddle before you're allowed to enter. A doctor and his son are in a car accident.
No, not that one. Say the one about the guy who hung himself with an ice block.
You just gave that one away. Answer this one. What animal walks on four legs in the morning?
That one's boring! I'm riddle president today. I get to pick.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Why is he president every time?
No, I've actually been a vote unclear on the election.
Oh, we should yesterday.
An empty bus pulls up to a stop and 10 people get on. At the next stop, 5 people get off, and twice as many people get on as at the first stop. At the third stop, 25 get off. So, which one of us is named Jim?
Am I Jim?
I thought he was Jim.
No, that's Bill.
Where's Bill?
You're Bill.
Oh, that's right.
You may as well enter as we sort this all out. Let's hope you're better than the last one.
Oh, and watch out for our brother down there. He's a bit odd.
Well, there you go. There's the sentient corn, just as promised. And that will be it for this video. So until next time, this has been WhyBeAre. I'll see ya.